Warm welcome to my next class. Rather, we must say it is our second unit titled The Sound of Music. In this title, we will discuss about that two important figures who have achieved name and fame in the field of music. The first story is about Evelyn Glennie. Evelyn Glennie listens to sound without hearing it. This is a story, not a story. This is a life history of a very popular, very famous, a very well-celebrated musician across the globe. By knowing the truth that she was completely deaf, you would be surprised. Our world is full of mysteries. In previous poem, we came to discuss about that one of our right choices can have drastic results, effects in our life for years to follow, and the effects may continue not only till our death, but it may continue to affect the people who are associated with us. Here are the examples of some people who are extraordinary, who are called specially abled people. We used to call them disabled people. But now the terminology is almost outdated. Instead, we should call these people specially abled people. Before I would say anything regarding the life story of Evelyn Glennie, my dear students, I may want to share a few lines regarding some of other great people who were specially abled, or who are disabled, who were handicapped by birth or by later, how they had written their successful stories and made examples, demonstrated exemplary life, extraordinary lives for the coming generation. You must have heard the name Beethoven. If you purchase a computer, along with the computer files, one program is already installed in the system, and that is Beethoven's Symphony of Beethoven. Beethoven is considered to be the first ever popular music composer who was a musician of Greece, ancient Greece. And even today, Beethoven's composed symphonies are widely used, and hundreds of crores of fans are there, even music lovers are there, who are considered to be the followers of Beethoven. But why should I tell more about Beethoven? Because Beethoven was a blind man. Beethoven fought against his disability. Beethoven was a blind man. But that blind man had made musical notes, composed several such wonderful songs, that his symphonies, His songs are even revered, respected, played, and given a lot of acknowledgement even today. Even after several centuries, even after millennia, he is revered. We must have heard the word Helen Keller. Helen Keller was a deaf and a blind woman. She was unable to see, she was unable to hear. Many such people are there who are disabled of some or other services, but Helen Keller was from both sides. She was unable to hear and she was unable to see. But from that position, from that point, Helen Keller became a very well-known writer. Until previous year, we had a novel in class 9th as NCERT's prescribed syllabus. We had a novel, long story novel, that was Story of a Young Girl. So this is all about the story of Helen Keller. Helen Keller became a very popular writer, even if she was, although she was blind as well as deaf. You must have heard the word Benjamin Braille, who himself was a blind but developed a script for the blind today, which is known as Braille script. I have got the fortune, I was fortunate enough to meet retired Major Devinder Pal Singh. Luckily, I got a chance to meet him in the previous year, in the month of November, when I went for a CBSE conference, and he was there by person. Major Devinder Pal Singh is the first blade runner of India. What is blade runner? You might be knowing that a person who is using artificial leg and become an athlete. He is the first blade runner of India. In the Kargil War 1999, Major Devinder Pal Singh lost his leg, and he then used artificial leg, blade legs. And on that blade leg, he started practicing, and he is the first blade runner of India. My dear students, I may tell about Tom, who is the first ever disabled person to scale Mount Everest. A man with an artificial leg who climbed at the top of the summit of Mount Everest, followed by an accident in the year of 1979, Tom had to go for an amputation of his leg. But with his one leg, with a one amputated leg, with an artificial amputated leg, Tom continued his effort, and in 1998, Tom became the first ever disabled person to reach at the top of Mount Everest. In this first part of our lesson, we will discuss about Evelyn Glennie, who lost her hearing when she was 11 years old, completely. But she became one of the most viewed, one of the most acknowledged musicians across the world. in the 20th century. We will discuss about Evelyn Glennie in the next episode.